warmly. I just have something to ask you before we start. Can we win?
Yeah!
Well, we sent Ronald Reagan back to his ranch?
Yeah!
I think so, too. I have a good feeling about Wisconsin. You have exercised great judgment in the people that you've chosen to lead you in public office. People of Wisconsin elected an outstanding governor, Tony Earl. And of course, my colleague in the House, Dave Obey, I know that you know that he is considered one of the most effective members of Congress, that he is one of the individuals who has worked very, very hard on the Budget Committee to make sure that fiscal responsibility is exercised by the federal government. And of course, it's also been said of him that he is one of the dozen or so members who really make a difference on the issues. Rick Mondale has spent his whole public life fighting for middle-income families and working people. Name a decent, noble cause, and Fritz has been in there fighting. While Ronald Reagan was making movies. Fritz Mondale was making history as a champion of civil rights and social justice. Corporation. Fritz Mondale was a spokesman for the average American family. Today, while Ronald Reagan jokes about bombing the Soviet Union, Fritz Mondale wants to negotiate with that tough adversary in control of the nuclear arms race.
Just a few miles from here, and Jerry, you may not know it, but this rain makes us grow. It produces Democrats. rejoices in the freedom of our spirit. Those are the stakes in this election. And before you make your final decision, I ask you to do exactly what you do when you approach the railroad tracks. Stop, look, and listen. This is your choice. It's your country. It's your future. Let's go there together. If you will help us, we're going to win it. I understand that this community is the home of H.B. Colton Ford. Is that correct? Great news, man, but he misjudged who won the election in 1948. He said Tom Dewey won tonight. Now, I loved H.B. Colton Ford, but he was wrong. And these pundits and savers.